guys, today we are going to be showing y'all how to make a Yu-Gi-Oh deck.
I bet you guys are wondering how to make one. Well, the basic moves are what you need. As you can see, I have my deck here. An attack monster. A pink card, which is called a trap card. And a blue card, which is called a spell card.
So yeah, we are going to be making a deck for you guys today.
I'm gonna put my deck right here. As you can see, I have my collection here.
As you can see, here are the cards that I just showed you. So I'm going to be making these cards out of decks for you. Alright, so let's see what we have for ourselves. Guys, the other basic stuff is look at the attack points and the defense points. And there is a mechanism where your monster could be in defense mode to protect your life points, or it could be in attack mode to attack your opponent's life points. So, and let's say you can't use this as a monster defense mode or anything. You have to actually like flip it over until your opponent falls into it, and then you flip it back. So, as you can see here, for an example, I have a board right here where you can put all of your cards down. As you guys can see, the artwork looks sick. But yeah, main monster zone is where you put monsters. Spell and trap zone is where you put your, like, you know what I just told you guys, your spell cards and trap cards. So, yeah. And later on, we are going to be doing a duel with the camera guy.
Hello! Also, his uncle.
for an example, this card, Swords of Revealing Light, that I have in my deck. So this card can block your opponent from attacking yourself for 3 exact turns.
Isn't this your face reveal too?
It is.
You haven't uploaded a video on YouTube, it's showing your face.
I don't care.
This is him in person. This is bluerocket.
I told you guys, I am gonna do a face reveal for y'all, and I did it. Shout out to Soldier on PS4.
And shout out to Splateen, his uncle on Switch.
Alright, as you can see, the box is open. We are going to be making the deck for you guys. So what you guys want to do is you guys want to put some powerful and weak monsters in your deck. The trick is to not put all powerful monsters in your decks, because if you put too much powerful monsters, your deck will like explode. Like, let's say there's a trap card here, right? Let's say of 100 machines. This trap card allows you to defeat a card that's level 6, 5. Oh, I'm sorry, I haven't explained that yet. So, what the level R is one, as you can see, 1, 2, 3, 4, right? So that's level 4. The stars count as your levels.
Oh, sorry guys, I have to cover the camera.
And there's also a thing called Sinker Summon. Sinker Summon, and I haven't
Secret,
set this.
I think it's Special Summon.
So you guys get an extra deck, but later on we are not going to be playing that way because I just don't want to. Alright, now let's get our deck. Let's see what we're doing. Ooh, good card from the example right here, the Blind Spot Strike. And also the rules of your deck is you need 50 cards or more cards. Let's see. Ooh, Dark Magician would be a good card too. If you guys want to put that in. And for an example, Blood Sorcerer, a good weak card. And as I was showing you, Scrap Bomb. And this trap card. This Bomba. Scrap Rage. The Hellfoot Apparel. And the Nimble Manta, for example. Only level 2. Ninja. So there's 2 more ninjas add to this. I think it is, if I'm not mistaken, fire and earth. So yeah, I'll put that in too. Ooh, the Rod of Mind's Eye. Let's see. Ooh, let's use the extreme one. And skilled dark magician. And skilled white. White Dark Magician, so there's a card called Polymerization card, which I do not have. He has it. And yes, you can fuse these two monsters together. And I think it is. I think you could actually turn this into Dark Magician. I'm not sure. Alright, also there is Odd Eyes Dragon, which I will add to the deck. Doc, Cyber Shield.
Instead of 2, there's 3.
You mean instead of 3, there's 4. Oh, another good card to explain to you guys. So I think you need to special summon these XYZ cards if I was not mistaken. So that's 2 level 4 monsters. Once per turn, you can detach 1 XYZ material from this card to target 1 defense position monster on the field. Change it to face up attack position. And if you do, it loses 600 attack points. So yeah, I will add that. Ooh, another good spell card. Ooh, the Great Shotgun Chamber. This is like one of the best cards ever. So if you control 2 or more samurai, 6 samurai monsters, you can special summon this card from your hand. Your opponent can only activate one spell card on each turn. If this card would be destroyed, you can destroy a face-up 6 samurai monster you control instead. And there's an XYZ. Oh no, never mind. There is an XYZ double back. So if someone, let's say
attacks you with this. So what you want to do is you want to flip this over, and the attack will go right to them, if I'm not mistaken. Instead of you going this over. So it wasn't polymerization for that card. It was actually Magician's Unite. You control two or more attack positions, splateen monsters, target one. Its attack. Oh, never mind. The attack becomes 3,000 until the end of phrase, but other splateen monsters you control cannot attack.
By phrase, it means turn.
A Gaga monster, target one card on the field and destroy that target. So basically what a Gaga monster is, for an example, let's see if I can find it here. Well, Gaga, it's doo-doo-doo, but what happened? I don't think so. Never mind, guys.
The only person that possesses a Gaga is me.
Yeah, he has Gaga Dark. Oh, Tower of... You see, for example, level 4 right here. After the storm is good, when someone uses like a heavy storm, or someone... These two.
And there's one special card in your deck. If you have this card, it allows you to resummon a monster.
Exactly.
Which card it is.
If you guys have two resonator monsters, which are these little, like, these little panda-type dudes, they're, like, evil, there's different types of them. Yeah, let's see. Ooh. For example, once per turn, when a level 4 or lower thunder type monster is normal special summon on the field, inflict 600 damage to your opponent. So I would use that because most of the cards are going to be level 4s.
And you just want to take down the candy man. Which is natural to happen.
Virus cannon here. So what virus cannon allows you to do is tribute any number of non-token monsters you control for tribute monster your opponent. Selects one spell card from their deck to your hand and sends it to the graveyard. And by the way guys, yes, this is on my another XYZ monster. So this one's even powerful. It's called Evorzar Lagia. See if I'm not pronouncing it in the right way, but yeah. Two level 4 dinosaur type monsters during either player's turn when the monsters would be normal or special summon or a spell card. Trap card is activated. Negate the summon or activate the
We got a flying thing. One more thing. Card for it. Alright, there you have it, guys. Creating a deck for y'all.
Battle time!
And thank y'all for watching, and we're about to upload a new video anyways, so see you there. Bye.
Okay, do the capture shot.